Hello, so I wanted to make a video about this railway crossing here, but the train is not yet coming, and then suddenly I discovered that there is also something like a haircutting saloon here behind that pile of roof tiles. There is this green dressed gentleman, and he told me, "Do you need a haircut?" So let's go to see his haircutting saloon. You see, there it is. Everything is there. I think I have been in such similar places already in Bangladesh. It was also very nice to be outside getting the haircut. You can see he has a stylish mirror here, which is recycled, but he did it in a very nice way by using the top of the triangle to be the peak of his wall decoration. Let's have a look at his tools. So here we have an electric shaver, which he will use with me, an extension cord to plug it in. There are all kind of combs. Okay, and then he has his different special scissors, you see, for making the hair less consistent. And then there's a shaver, which is like the same as they had hundreds of years ago, but we all still use them. You can switch the blades. And here's an interesting pair of scissors, which has a, looks like it is even like, this is a haircutting scissor, yeah, or some, yeah, doctor's? Aha, yeah. Uh-huh, very nice shape. Okay, and then there's still another razor. Alut blade head, new blade, so let's make sure he has this. There's something to brush the hair, there are lotions. Head massage also,
head massage.
My goodness, he's also doing head massage.
Head massage.
Massage. Ah, massage, massage.
Aha, uh-huh, okay, okay, okay. So, you covering and then I make video. So we have the... This, no
same,
problem?
Same, same.
Aha. So we have here some assistant. They are also having a look at me while I get my hair cut. There's a travel case under the table. There's a small bicycle. I'm making a tour of the place because I think it's just so nice to make a difference with some normal hair salons where you know already how everything will be. And here suddenly you have banana plants 10 meters from your hair cutting seat. So here I go through these banana plants, and there we are. This is the place. So let's start to get the haircut here. Okay, I'm ready. Yamu. So I have 2 times Sinopharm vaccination. I think I can remove that mask now. Sinopharm already 2 times. Let's go maybe 3 times, 4 times, but the mask is now really too much. Okay, so he will make a haircut of my white long hair. You do the sides only.
Oh, okay.
This on top you leave a little bit longer, little, because a little bit hot, you know, not to get some insulation. And yamu. So usually I'm filming other people getting a haircut, and this time it will be like this because we have such a nice place and there's nobody else to hold the camera. Okay. And I'm really happy because this gentleman was giving me advice on the hours, when the train will pass, because I wanted to make a train railway crossing video. And then they knew all the hours because they are right beside the rail tracks. And they knew in which direction to where, I mean, what's the name of the train and where it's going and where it's coming from. I just took the hours, I wrote them down.
Sir, I plus.
Ah, okay. Yes, these need to go off. And then he was telling me everything very precisely. I wrote it down, so I know that I should come a little bit more early, because now it was basically 10 o'clock and the 10 o'clock train was already on its way. It already passed the place, so I came too late, even though I was on the time, because it's a little bit flexible apparently, the time when the train is passing. And I can come back here, get a head massage, wait for my train, make a train video for all the train spotters, because the train spotters are those who love trains for some reason, you know. We are not really sharing the same passion because I'm making videos for train spotters, but I'm not really a train spotter. But I love to make them happy, and by making these videos of trains passing, I got new knowledge about this hobby. Some people commented to me about the sound of the signals. Can you imagine? So there was somebody, I very much like his comment. He told me, do you know that in some place, which is I think more than 80 kilometers from Gaul, there is a special signal which is from this and this country, because they are having sometimes some apparently imported signal devices. And he said that's very rare. Could you one day make a video of that one? So yes, I will go there one day if I'm passing there anyhow, and I will wait for the train to record that special signal sound and the video of the train passing. So this is all part of my hair cutting video now, because I better make it a little bit more interesting than just looking at me getting a haircut. And now I cannot see very clear without my glasses, but let's have a look still again at all these nice things which are on display here. I didn't even ask how much cost that haircut, because it's just all right. They will never overcharge you. They're very friendly, and even if they would, I think it would never be as much as we have to pay in Europe for the same kind of haircut anyhow. So we are always the privileged ones. And you can see here this comfortable bench with some thick cushions. There's a well there also with a bucket, so if electricity fails you can still get water. And there are coconut trees. You can see on top there are coconuts in the trees, ready to be collected. Maybe I can order one. That would be just nice for this video. Paul, pull one, order ikke. Drink the coconut, pull one.
Lie.
Not ready.
Not ready.
Okay. So the coconuts need to ripen. Then it will be maybe for the next time. Okay, I think I must slow him down a little bit.
Little.
Yeah, because the sun is very hot. I think one time I got an insulation, I didn't even know. So this lady is the young mother of this grown-up hairdresser. He's actually still in his parents' home working. And you can see, even I noticed there's an electricity clock. It's made by Ceylon Electricity Board. This Ceylon Electricity Board,
yes,
huh?
Yes.
So you see that house is just a wooden shed with a little bit of roof, metal sheet roof on top, and looks like construction which is supposed to be temporary. No, they really have a connection for the current, and that's the way it is possible to live in Sri Lanka too. You can get everything legal. You can get your current connected, even if your house is a little bit more modest. And still they don't want to have a water pump here for the... They still get the water by hand. Very good. Good luck on that, yeah. Can you make the head massage, please?
Yeah.
Thank you. That will be also part of the video. Now I can live without the head massage, but okay. Isn't it nice to show that you get this in Sri Lanka from the hairdressers? It is an interesting experience, because there are different styles of doing that head massage. I had some people who did it pretty rough, so I had to get that surprise that I was a little bit shaken after this. But there are some others, they are having very skilled fingers to somehow stimulate some nerves in your scalp and skull, and then you feel really better, and they put some lotion, so there's probably some alcohol inside, and that also gives a cool feeling on the head, beside the fact that the skin is also better irrigated. And sometimes when you're in the tropical countries, your head may be itchy despite the fact that you wash all the time. Now, I don't have a dandruff problem at all, but the skin definitely can sometimes just be probably cleaned up from microscopic small nasty animals living on your skin. What?
Backside cross.
You can help it with the shaving a little bit.
Trimmer.
Yeah, you trim this, please. What time coming the next train? Still
11:30.
11:30.
Ah, so that is, we will wait for this one. We will wait. I want to sit here and have that train in the mirror passing. That would be great. And we will extend the session.
Okay.
Better. So he's disinfecting the shaving handle. And then we get the brand new blade. So these are the hygienic rules respected even in the most open airspace hair salons. There we go. So he's going to shave some of my hair with that. Putting some alcohol before all around.
Yeah, powder.
Mm-hmm. Talc, huh? Talcum powder. Now all the cut hair is taken off. And I get some new towel. Wow. So this is the beginning of the head massage. He has this little bag. He needs a pair of scissors. He's asking to his mother the pair of scissors. And he will have these different products he will now apply to my scalp. The smell is nice. It's a little bit like smoky smelling kind of perfume I would appreciate. Scent on that? Look at this scent.
Red.
Huh?
Berum. Pollen.
Wait, I look.
Colin.
What is that? Wait, what is that smell? This is another product. Okay. Pouring this content of this bottle, my head. He's putting quite a lot.
Cool.
Okay, I think, careful, you don't need to empty the whole bottle. Hurry. This is the moment to really close your eyes, and because of the video now I'm not as much as relaxing as I would if I would not do that video. If you close your eyes, you can really relax when the head massage is well done. Now the head massage can in some places extend till the neck, which is good because you know, when you drive a vehicle or even you are looking at your phone and you usually have tendency to put your head in a not natural position, something we should be aware of, that it will create tensions in the muscles, and these head massages are helping to just release the muscles. So the skilled head massage performer is aware of these muscles. And then you have some, they even extend the head massage to the muscles close to the neck on the shoulders. So that is, let's see how much this artist is going to extend this head massage. Everything, of course, till the shoulders, and that's it. They don't go lower. That is not part of the hairdresser's duties. The smell is pleasant. It's now like mint. No, Facebook, no. YouTube. Hey, YouTube. They're speaking in Tamil.
YouTube.
Facebook, no, I don't care for Facebook. I'm joking. Suddenly I start to see some white dots.
My friend.
Somebody came to have a look what's going on here. Ah, now we are going to the shoulders. You see, that's what I said. I will help him. I will open the button of my shirt because I'm not shy to show my shoulders, no problem. Oh, yeah, you can do that. Oh, my goodness. Yeah, you can do the shoulders too. He's now extending to the shoulders outside parts too. This is not everybody's type of head massage, but the shoulders are definitely included till this area here. I had this many times before. Now, in the end, we'll find out how reasonably I will be charged for this massage.
Hi.
Oh, good. Now, ears are also getting a massage.
Finish. No.
He's not doing something. Oh my goodness, I felt like a crack. What was that? He's just careful. Oh my god, I could feel something. What is that? I had a crack. I never had that before. I really need to trust him. Okay, that there was that crack, you know, I really heard it until my brain. Now it's just water.
Water.
It feels cool. Mm. Oh, there's that interesting comb which has a little bit of parting already. Now, it's not a video about me, it's a video about this man for me, because I have this collection of videos about people doing work in Sri Lanka, all kind of jobs. You can check on the channel. There are many more. And usually I'm not part of the video myself, except as the one who makes
it. Okay, sir.
Yeah, very good.
Oh,
let's put back my shirt. So, Yalwa, this kid, I ask him how much money he will take. 350 rupees. So that is really a bargain. That's $1.50 or something like that. Here, I give you a tip, Pansia Dana, today, because you have been also my actor. Everything included, Pansia. Hari?
Okay.
Satu tui. So okay. Don't misunderstand. The 350 was the price, and I gave 150 because I'm very happy. And I want to support this small business here. This, how many years already working? Oyage kade? Oyage saloon? Vayase kiyada? Saloon?
Saloon service 24?
No, you.
Saloon service?
Yeah. How many years already working this saloon?
My.
Your father?
Oh.
Tata? Tata already wedding here.
Yes. Your tata is cutting.
Ah, his father was also here.
His father is
same
cutting.
Place.
Yes.
Samana place, very famous. And tata koeda?
No.
Tata no.
Don't.
Merila.
Yeah.
Ah, father already died.
You son. The mother.
Son took over, huh?
Yeah.
Ah, and you oyage working here kiyada? 24 years?
Yeah.
No, you are 24 years old. Oyage vayase kiyada?
Vayasa 42.
42? This tarunai. This man is 42. I thought he's like 24.
Yeah.
Ah, and you work here 24 years already?
24.
No wonder the father already died. I thought that he's
I'm pudunam bende.
Huh?
42.
42? Well, you're well preserved. Next customer coming.
Coming. Oh.
Customer.
Coming.
Ah, okay. Okay. Yeah, next customer coming. To go to the same place. Why not? It's easy to find. It's very close to the road between Galle and Dewata. Not far from that big Sahana restaurant. It's on the railway side. He's writing down his phone number now. You can see. And he speaks English. So he's giving his phone number. I put it in the description of the video. Your phone number, speak. 077?
Not 77.
Yes.
46.
Yes.
18.
Uh-huh.
233.
Okay. Well done. Where did you learn English?
Huh?
Where did you learn English? Your English class, Koida?
English class, no. Little English.
No, I would like to speak Singhalese like you do English, but...
Name, Umar.
Kumar.
Umar, like the
leader of the Muslim. Yeah, this Umar, friend of the Muhammad, no?
Abdullah Muhammad.
Yes. Okay, and I will wait for the train now. I wait Kochi after make a video, okay?
11:30.
Okay, I will be here. Actually, I will come back. Goodbye, madam. I will come back when the train is passing to show you that train still close to this place. So we have the whole location now on this video. It's blinking all the time, the signal. And here's the truck.